Peter comes in the other day and says, have you got something that would let me put my smartphone on my binocular? Now, this is quite a straightforward idea. The modern smartphone with apps like the one I've got on here, GoSkyWatch, can give you a very good interactive view of the night sky with a reasonable standard of positional accuracy that would allow this to be used as a finder on an instrument like a telescope or on a binocular. So putting the two ideas together, the binocular and the smartphone, is quite a good idea. And I took this as an excellent opportunity to start giving it that about how I'd done this years ago when the iPhone 3 came out, and I'd made a nice little adapter for it, and one thing led to another and they weren't made anymore and I didn't have any in the shop and I couldn't help the chap. And then I suddenly thought, hold the phone, I can do this. I can add these two parts together really quite easily with the accessories that I've already got in the store that are not specialist binocular mounts, but I can phone to binocular mounting rather, but I can easily put them together and make this work quite nicely. And if you hang around till after we've identified ourselves in the next 10 seconds, I'll show you how to do it. Okay, so how do we do it? How do we put our smartphone on our binocular? And don't forget, there's lots of different designs of binoculars and there's quite a few different designs of smartphones. So how do we bring these two ideas together? Well, the very first thing we need is some kind of a holder for the smartphone. Now, the cheapest type of holder for the smartphone that I've come across is one that equips the smartphone to simply be used as a camera. And for that purpose, it's simply a method of adding tripod mounting bushes to the smartphone. So basically, bracket like this. The one that I'm showing you here is branded Revelation Astro, and I got this from Telescope House. It's not expensive, and it's basically it doesn't allow the smartphone to be put on a telescope. It doesn't allow it to be put on a binocular. It's just a means of attaching it to a tripod. So we take our smartphone and we put that in this way round with the screen on the inside, and we can see that I've now basically turned my smartphone into a tripod mountable camera. So that's the first step, is something like this. The second stage is we need to have a method of mounting it to the binocular. Now, this is where a standard binocular bracket comes in. Now, the design of these things is such that they normally fit on the tripod boss at the front of the binocular. All the binoculars we've got here have got one of these. You can see it right at the front here. That's the one requirement of your binocular. It's got to have a tripod mounting boss. Most of the brackets obviously look something like this when you fit them, with the foot ending up being at the bottom so that we can mount it on a tripod. Now, it's quite obvious that what we're going to do is turn this up the other way. But that's actually too high. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the knob out of the top, fit it into the bottom of the tripod mounting bush, and mount it really the sort of wrong way round, as you can see here. I'm going to shove this in so that the bracket is now sticking out the front. Now, I'm sure you can imagine what's going on here. Now, it really is a very simple idea now. All we've got to do now is mount our bracket directly to the front of that, and we've accomplished our aim. We've mounted the smartphone on the binocular. One of the reasons I like the Revelation Astro version here is the kit actually comes complete with these two additional screws, and these are ideal because I can put one in the front here. I mean, in all fairness, if your adapter doesn't come with this, you could always just get a quarter Whitworth or quarter UNC screw to make this work, but the Revelation Astro one actually comes with these included. So there it is. In just a few seconds, I've got myself a rather nice finder for my binocular just by putting these two ideas together. Now, selecting the bracket is obviously the binocular mounting bracket is a bit critical. This type is no good. The ones that have got a solid block at the bottom, you're not really going to be able to use that. So they need to be eliminated from your inquiries. You're going to need an open metal simple bracket like this one, or the one we've got here, or the one you saw me use earlier. The other consideration is that a lot of the brackets that have got a thin neck often have quite a thick base. And given that you're going to use the base to create this platform to sit the smartphone bracket on, you want one that's going to fit into that gap. And you can see that this one won't. It won't actually allow me to put the screw in there. It doesn't actually come to the right position. So it's all very well that the top end, the narrow end, would fit in there. But the smartphone is going to end up way too high. It's not comfortable if the smartphone ends up 3 or 4 inches above the binocular. It's better by far if the smartphone ends up at a much lower profile at the front. So you've only got to, you know, you want it so that you've only got to glance up along the top of the binocular for this to work. Anyway, that's for you to sort out. I've got my one ready to go. If you want to see more like this, don't forget to subscribe, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Bye for now.